Like a Boss is the first R-rated comedy of the decade, for some reason. And it's about Mia and Mel, two best friends who have been friends since middle school, and who run a very wealthy makeup business, and that holds very dear and near to them. But when a very wealthy businesswoman wants to buy their company, it puts their friendship in jeopardy, and now it's up to the girls to find a way to maintain this successful business offer, and also being best friends. As you can imagine, I was not looking forward to this movie. The movie looked really bad, the trailers didn't do anything for me, and it just looked like another generic R-rated female comedy that we get every few weeks or so. But I still wanted to give it the benefit of a doubt, and Bad Boys for Life wasn't out this weekend. So I saw the movie, and guys, let me tell you, it was everything I expected it to be. It was just another lame, generic R-rated comedy that we get every week or so often that everyone will talk about and then literally forget the next day. Okay, first off, the positives. Let's start the year positive, even though this is a terrible movie. First off, I actually quite liked a couple jokes. Some jokes did catch me off guard and had me laughing my ass off. And I also liked the acting in this movie, particularly Salma Hayek. She was easily the best character in this movie. She was going all out, and you could tell she's having a lot of fun. And I liked the chemistry between Rose Byrne and Tiffany Haddish. In fact, I pretty much like the entire cast. It's just that they're wasted on, but more on that later. And I guess my last positive thing I can say about this movie is that there are moments in here where they try to be emotional and genuinely heartfelt, and it actually worked and surprised me, because there are some really solid heartfelt moments in this movie that really caught me off guard. But I wish that was more of that in here, but there wasn't, unfortunately. That's like about maybe 15% of the movie. That small chance of heartfelt moments in here is just 15%. The rest of this movie, oh boy. Okay, first let's start by saying the obvious. This movie is not funny. Yeah, there are a couple jokes that made me laugh here and there, but the majority of the movie is so unfunny. The movie thinks that constantly saying the same sex jokes over and over again and constantly swearing and being loud and obnoxious is the equivalent of true comedy. No. You have to actually write jokes revolving around the raunch and the sex and the loudness. Don't just have the raunchiness be the joke, but unfortunately, that's what the filmmakers thought, and that's what we got here. And it's, like I said before, not funny. The characters in this movie are also painfully bland. Yeah, I like Salma Hayek and the gay best friend in the movie, but everyone else was painfully bland. Tiffany Haddish is playing the same character she always does, and Rose Byrne is severely wasted, which is unfortunate because I like seeing these two together because they felt like genuine friends. I wish they were in a better movie. Same goes for the cast. Like I said before, they're all wasted. They've shown in much better movies that they can do good comedy and they can be genuinely funny, but here their talent is wasted, which is unfortunate. And speaking of which, these characters are really inconsistent, particularly the other group of friends that the main characters are friends with that you see time and time again in the movie. I have no idea what to feel about these characters, because on one hand, in like one scene, these characters are like friends with Mia and Mel, like they're happy to see them, they're cheering, they're drinking wine, and it's happy. But in like 3 seconds later, they're yelling at them and cussing them out like, are they friends with them or not? Like, you can't go from one scene, one emotion to another in the span of 3 seconds. Like, come on. And then there's the product placement. Oh my god. It's not as bad as something like Man of Steel or anything, but they don't do it in a subtle way like most movies do, where there's some product placement here, but you don't recognize it. No, it's full on screen. These products are fully on screen with their names across the board. There's a whole joke dedicated to Zillow. It's that bad, people. And lastly, while there is a good message in here about friendship and never letting those dear and near to your heart go and, realizing your flaws, and yes, that is a good message, I would have appreciated it a lot more if it wasn't hammered down my throat, because there is not a moment in this movie where a character does not talk about friendship or being your friends or how having friends is important to you. And it just gets on my nerves, because every second they're talking about how good friends they are, and they don't show how good their friends they are, because the whole movie, these two friends, they're just bickering and yelling at each other, and they're just telling the audience and just forcing this message down your throat. It's almost like a My Little Pony episode, but worse, honestly, because they keep hammering this dumb message, while good and important, down your throat, and got on my nerves. So yeah, like a boss, it's really bad. Yeah, it has its moments. There are some funny moments here and there. I liked the chemistry between Rose Byrne and Tiffany Haddish, and Salma Hayek is the best character, but it's just another January arty comedy that's going to get outnumbered and forgotten by the time Bad Boys and Birds of Prey come out, and will be more successful and more praised than this movie will ever be, because jokes are unfunny, it has really bland and inconsistent characters, the product placement is obnoxious, and the message is forced upon down your throat. I know I'm supposed to say that this movie's bad, don't see it, but I already feel like none of you have seen it, so go see Bad Boys this weekend. And those were my thoughts on Like a Boss. What did you guys think of it? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Comment down below and let me know. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you like this channel, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on all social media links at the end of the video. And until next time, guys, stay sharp. Talk to corporate. Approve memos. Lead a workshop. Remember birthdays. Direct workflow. My own bathroom. Micromanage. Promote synergy. Hit on Deborah. Get rejected. Swallow sadness. Send some facts.